Good morning, everybody. It's Pykel with League of Items, and it's another day where we do a pretty good job of figuring out what's going to happen and still lose a little bit of money. But that's okay. I forgive you. So I only ran six lineups yesterday because I thought the slate was pretty ugly looking, and I didn't have any takes that I thought I could like leverage really well except for Gen G. So I just played a bunch of Gen G lineups. Let's go through what I said yesterday in Discord. So I said, I don't love this slate. Both Gen G and T1 are live. I'm a T1 fan, so I don't know if I can trust my thoughts on the matchup. My gut says Gen G is undervalued because everyone is excited by T1's youth and willingness to fight now, and they played well against Damwon Gaming, but I have the feeling that Gen G can beat them and exploit the new aggression. That was what I had for the first match. World Elite over TT 100% all day, never playing TT in this type of slate. Will be extremely contrarian, so if you want to, good luck, but that's not a play that I'm making. I said same thing for Damwon Gaming. RNG should be a huge favorite over OMG, and they are. I want to say that OMG has a chance, but it's tough to honestly think that, and now they're bringing in a backup in the top lane too. RNG, World Elite, and Damwon Gaming, and then make up your mind for yourself about T1 and Gen G. I think it, meaning T1 Gen G, could be surprisingly high scoring, especially if Gen G wins. So that's why I kind of went with Gen G yesterday. And yeah, I still lost a little bit of money. The first place lineup was pretty interesting because it was a 4-2-1 with six favorites that got game not played bonus wins, and then Fredit Breon that had the gigantic upset over Damwon Gaming. So it's interesting because you could probably try to make the argument that if every single player in your lineup gets a game not played bonus and your team slot loses, like, you could theoretically have a chance to win still. It's very unlikely, but I don't know if I could really suggest making this kind of lineup, because the chances of Fredit Breon not only winning but going 2-0 is extremely low. But hey, it worked, so there's not much to say. And like I said in a previous video, I think, it might have been on the Infinity Edge podcast, that's how Awesome O plays. He just tries to get 150 unique lineups, I think, and if it hits, it hits. And when they hit, they win big. So that's basically it. Let's take a look at the LCK and LPL matches for tomorrow. Also, there's an LEC slate. I might do a longer video on this later today. But I'll probably just do it right now. A shorter version of it right now. So first up, let's get the odds on the screen. All right, so the LPL, we have, let's do LCK first. LCK, KT Rolster against Homolife. Homolife is a relatively large favorite, which I don't disagree with. I know some people were big on KT going into the season, but I like Hanwha Life a decent amount. So I would be playing Hanwha Life in this spot. I think Chovy and Deft really haven't shown much this season so far, and I think that they're going to get into a stride and be a competitive top four team. That's just, I do think that's going to happen at some point. Then the other matchup is DRX against Sandbox. So DRX is a favorite here because of their win against a Freak of Freaks, or Nongshim, and they beat a Freak of Freaks. I think that this is a spot where DRX is probably overrated. I think that this is probably just a 50-50 match, and the line kind of agrees with me. So this is a good spot to play live Sandbox, I think. I'll probably have exposure to DRX anyways, just a little bit. You're probably just going to end up playing both sides of this one. LPL, Rare Atom against Bilibili Gaming. So we have Cube against BewBew. They're about the same. We have Aix or Leon against Meteor are about the same. Fofo against Zika, I think Zika is the better player. iBoy against Aiming, I think Aiming is the better player. And then Hung against Mark, I think that they're about even. So I'll be on BLG tonight. I'll probably make them one of my... that like this is a slate where I'll probably just play my 10 to 15 lineups and or 10 to 20 lineups and see if I can get some unique lineups. Because I like BLG a lot. I think that they're going to be good long-term. And then EDG against JDG. EDG has been pretty good. JDG has had some disappointing losses, right? Yeah, they lost to Invictus Gaming, beat Billy Billy Gaming. EDG has beaten LGD, FPX, and OMG. So they're looking good right now. JDG is a minus 150 favorite. That's a little surprising. Because I do agree that EDG has had a better season so far. This might be a spot where you just play JDG. So I think that just like a first glance, I like Humblelife, I like BLG. I like both of these teams. And then I like both of these last teams. If I had to make a choice in all these spots just for like ownership reasons and like being unique and building lineups that I think have a chance to come in first place on their own, I'd probably play DRX. I think Sandbox, I wonder if people are more convinced by Sandbox or DRX. I'm not sure about that. And then I'll probably play EDG. So you can get some double dog lineups in tonight, which is always fun. But that's basically it. I was gonna do this. So let's do this today. I'm gonna go through every matchup. So Doodoo against Doran. I think that Doran is the better player. Cube against Bubu, I think is about even. Kingen against Summit, I think is about even. And then Zoom against Flandre, I think Zoom is better. So if I was gonna rank like best matchups, I would say the difference between Flandre and Zoom is pretty similar to the difference between these other top lane matchups. But this is the one matchup where like I think Zoom is like one of the best top laners in the world. Flandre is in a tier below that. Kingen and Summit, I would say, are probably in the same tier. Cube and Bubu, I would say, are probably in the same tier. And then Doodoo and Doran, I'd say Doran's probably a tier above Doodoo, but I think Morgan and Doran are in the same tier. So, or at least very close. So I think that it's interesting that Doodoo is the one who's playing recently. And then let's go to jungle. Arthur against Blank, I think they're about the same. Aches and Meteor, I think they're about the same. Piosik and Kroko. I think that Kroko has good upside, but right now I think we kind of have to say that Piosik is better. And then Kanavi and Jai Jai, I think that Kanavi is better. All right. Let's go mid lane. So Chovy against Yukal or Dove. Chovy is definitely better. Fofo against Zika. I really do think Zika is better. I'm surprised they have it listed any other way. Solka and Fate, I think, are probably about the same. I think Solka does have good upside, though. They've been playing really well so far. Yagao, Xie, and Scout. I think they're all in a similar tier. I like Xie a lot, but I know that Scout's been around forever and it's always been really good, so I'm not like crazy. AD carry. Deft and Hybrid, Deft is better. iBoy and Aiming, I really do think Aiming is better. Bao and Leo or Root, I think that's about the same. And then Loken against Viper, I think they're about the same. So Loken and Viper are top tier AD carries. Aiming is a top tier AD carry. iBoy is considered a top tier AD carry by some people. I don't think so. Deft is a top tier AD carry, but a lot of people are skeptical of Deft at this point. And then last up we have Vista against Zeus. I don't know about that. Hong and Mark, doesn't really matter. Becca and Effort, doesn't really matter. Lu Mao and Mako, two of the better supports in the LPL. So that's The big edges there, I think, are things like Zika, because I think Zika long-term is going to be thought of as a very good mid laner, as opposed to Fofo, who I don't ever think will be in that tier of player, based off of what we've seen from their career so far. With Zika, we've seen like hot, very high upside. So that's it for the LPL LCK slate. And then we have the LEC coming back tomorrow. So let me put this over here. So first match, G2 against Mad Lions. Armut is a big upgrade over Arome for Mad Lions, which is good. G2 is going to be extremely popular. Yonkos over El Yoya. El Yoya is probably a better fit for the meta than Yonkos, but we're getting into a spot where like Olaf and things like that are becoming much more popular again, and that's better for Yonkos than El Yoya, I think. Caps and Humanoid. Caps is the better player. Reckless against Karzi. Mickey against Kaiser. So Mickey and Reckless are better than Karzi and Kaiser, like long term, but in individual matchups, I could see Karzi kind of going off, especially in this kind of meta with like Kai'Sa and Samira and things like that. He has that playmaking upside. I do prefer G2, but Mad Lions is a team that I will also have exposure to, because in matches that Mad Lions wins, they could definitely come in first place. But both, I think both of those teams are going to be pretty popular. SK against Astralis. SK Gaming is a small favorite. Gen X against White Knight are about the same. Gen X did have some good points last season. Tinx against Zanzara. I like Tinx a lot. Tinx is pretty good. Blue against Nuke Duck. Nuke Duck is the worst mid laner in the LEC. Jezu and Jeskla. Don't care. Treats and Promise Q. Don't care. Rogue and XL. Ottawamne against Cries is pretty even. Inspired against Dan is probably Inspired favored. Larson against Chekalod is probably Larson favored. But I do like Chekalod. Hansama against Patrick. Hansama and Shrimby are better than Patrick and Torre. And I'm not sure about Hansama on Kai'Sa and Samira. It's intuitively, it seems like they should be champions that he's good at, but I've never seen him play it, I don't think. Like, I don't have any memorable performances of that. Although, I guess the year that Misfits went pretty deep at Worlds, I think that's when Kai'Sa was really popular, so maybe Hansama was playing that at that point. That's something to check on if you're interested. Schalke against Vitality. Broken Blade and Shigenda are pretty similar, but Broken Blade's a little better, I think. Gilius, I think, is still better than Skeens. I just like Gilius's playstyle. Abadage against Militza. I think they're probably closer than people realize. Neon against Comp. Neon and Comp are about the same. And then Limit and Labrov are about the same. I would say Comp and Labrov had a better year last year. Like, relative to expectations and relative to their, like, win-loss record. I thought they were pretty solid all year. Bwipo and Hyrit or Aggressivo. I don't know who's starting, but Bwipo is better. Self-made against Razork. Radwalk! Self-made is better. Niski and Viteo. Viteo and Niski are... Niski is better. We should assume that Niski is better, because we haven't seen Viteo play against the highest level of players, but I think Niski's overrated. Upset and Kabe, they're pretty similar. They're both very good. Hillisong and Denik or Vander. I hope it's Vander, but Hillisong is better. If I had to pick the five winners for tomorrow, it would be G2 in this matchup. I do like SK Gaming better. I think Tinx is just better than Zanzara. I do like Rogue more than XL, but I do think XL has a chance to win. Rogue might be a little overrated by other people this year. And I do think they're a good team. I'm just saying, like, it wouldn't shock me if XL was the kind of team that could take a map off of Rogue and, like, turn a DraftKings slate on its head. Schalke against Vitality. I think Vitality is a good leverage spot, because everyone's going to remember Schalke being good at the end of the season. We'll see if that rings true. The first slate's always tough to gauge where people are going to come in on. And then Fnatic's better than Misfits. So that's it. That's all I got for you today. I got to go to work. But thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.